We will now create a transaction for countries. We call it country. And here we create a country identifier attribute, country ID. And we can see that GeneXus has assigned it the ID domain. We create an attribute to store the name of the country, country name, which takes the name domain. We save. And note that, just as it did with customer, GeneXus has automatically created the form to add, edit, and delete countries. Let's go back to the attraction transaction. We want to assign a country to each attraction. Note that typing the letter C displays the list of attributes existing in the knowledge base that begin with this letter. We select country ID, and its entire definition is displayed. In this transaction, we will also include the country name attribute, because when we execute this transaction and select a country identifier, we will want to see the corresponding country name. Let's focus on these two attributes included in more than one transaction. We will find out what role they play here in attraction. Let's remember that country ID is the identifier or key in the country transaction. To be more precise, from now on, we will say that country ID is the primary key of the country transaction. And when a primary key is included in another transaction, it has the role of foreign key. Including an attribute that is a transaction primary key in another transaction allows us to relate both transactions. This means that, when executing the attraction transaction, for this attribute, we will have to enter a value that has been previously recorded through the country transaction. Let's see it at runtime. We press F5, and GeneXus analyzes the impact caused by the new definitions made on the knowledge base, and informs us that a new table called country will have to be created in the database with the country ID and country name fields. In addition, a new table called attraction will also be created with the fields attraction ID, attraction name, and country ID. Note that in the attraction physical table that will be created by GeneXus, the country name attribute is not included, even though we had included it in the attraction transaction structure. This happens because the transaction concept is not the same as the physical table concept. Remember that transaction is the GeneXus object we created in the knowledge base to represent an object or actor of reality. And in examining it, GeneXus creates a physical table in the database to store the data that will be entered when executing the transaction. We must be aware that not all the attributes included in a transaction structure will later be stored in the physical table created based on this transaction. Storing the country name in several physical tables would mean storing duplicate data. Instead, the country name can be retrieved from a single location where it's stored, which is to say, from the country table. We go back to the development environment and click on Reorganize. The term reorganize means to reorganize the database. That is to say, it refers to the task of making changes to it. GeneXus creates the programs to change the database and executes them, making the necessary changes. Next, it generates the necessary programs corresponding to the application itself. For example, for each new transaction that we've defined, programs are being generated in the selected programming language to enter, change, and delete countries and tourist attractions. Note that we quickly have our application running again in a web browser. Now we have links to work not only with clients, but also with attractions and countries. Let's add data about some countries. Since the country ID attribute was previously defined as belonging to the ID domain, and this domain has the auto number property set to true, we don't have to enter a value for the identifier, because it'll be numbered automatically. We add Brazil, France, and China. We browse the data to confirm that they've been numbered. And we execute the attraction transaction. We add the tourist attraction, Louvre Museum. And here again, we don't have to enter a value for the identifier, so we type the name Louvre Museum. Now we have to indicate that the Louvre Museum is in France. If we remember the identifier number of France, we can enter it. But another option is to select it from a list by clicking on this arrow. Note that this list displays all the countries that we've entered. And we select France. Note that the country identifier 2 has been loaded. We press the tab key, and the country name is displayed. Note that we cannot change the country name from here, because it's displayed only for reading purposes. Remember that a selection arrow was automatically displayed next to country ID, and provided a list of available countries. The arrow was displayed next to this attribute in particular because, as we've said before, here country ID is a foreign key, because that same attribute is primary key for another transaction. So here, the user will have to enter a value that has been previously registered as primary key value through the country transaction. Therefore, GeneXus collaborates by generating and offering a list of countries available. Here we can see in GeneXus the object implemented by that list. Now we will see at runtime how the country and attraction transactions check that the values entered for the country ID attribute are consistent. We will enter a new attraction, such as the Pyramids of Egypt. In the country field, we enter the value 4 because we think it corresponds to Egypt, but an error is displayed because country 4 doesn't exist. We check the registered countries and see that we'd only entered country 1, 2, and 3, but not 4. Likewise, if we want to change an attraction that has already been entered and try to replace its country with another country that doesn't exist, let's say 4 again, we get the same error message. Which is to say, when we enter or change data through transactions, the associated data is automatically checked for consistency. Also, when we try to delete data through transactions, the necessary controls are made to maintain the consistency of the stored data. Now, for instance, if we try to delete the country France, we will see a message informing us that the deletion cannot be performed because related data exists in attraction. Remember that we entered the Louvre Museum that belongs to France. Now, one thing that is very important to learn is that attributes must be named using exactly the same name when they're related to the same concept. For example, if in the attraction transaction, instead of entering the country ID attribute, we had typed country identifier, for GeneXus, country ID and country identifier would be different attributes. And for this reason, in attraction, it would not have checked if the value entered in the country identifier existed in the country table. And it wouldn't have offered the country selection list in the attraction transaction. Also, it wouldn't be possible to retrieve the name of the corresponding country because country name could be referenced in the attraction transaction due to the fact that country ID plays the role of foreign key and retrieves its corresponding country name. But country identifier is not a foreign key because it isn't the primary key of any transaction, so it isn't possible to retrieve data associated with this attribute. Let's continue to represent more features of the travel agency's reality. We've been told that every attraction has an associated category to indicate if it's a monument, a museum, a park, and so on. And here we have the same situation that we saw with countries. We will create a categories transaction and assign the attractions categories. Let's do it now. We create the category transaction with category ID and category name. And now we add attributes to the attraction transaction. Category ID and category name. Before trying this at runtime, we can allow the category not to be set, for example, because we don't know its value at the time of entering the attraction. This is done by changing the value of the nullable property of the category ID attribute. We set it to yes. This only makes sense for foreign keys that reference values from another table. Let's implement another request of the travel agency. For each attraction, they want to enter its photo. So in the attraction transaction, we enter an attribute called attraction photo. It'll be of image type, because this type makes it possible to store images. Now we press F5 to apply the changes to the database and programs and run the application. Note that a new table will be created in the database to store the categories. If we click on attraction, we are told that the attraction table has to be converted, which means that the category ID and attraction photo attributes have to be added. This element is added to store the file, and to give the option to only reference a URL to it. We press the Reorganize button. The browser is opened, and we start to enter some categories. We entered these categories: Museum and Monument. Now we execute the attraction transaction. We can see that it allows us to enter a category and a photo. We search for the Louvre Museum, and we assign it the museum category and a photo. And we confirm. Lastly, we send the changes we've made to the GeneXus server.